We're going to bring on the brother that just got a major victory from over Matt Santos. And you know they're bringing in all this genetically modified scientific garbage, yes, aka devil's food, to destroy Africa, to break down the fertility, and to break down the mind so they can rob us.
Yes.
But they mistaken this time because we're here. We're going to kick them out. And this brother, working with food sovereignty of Ghana to make sure that Monsanto's and all the rest of these devils stay out of Africa. So let us bring forth our brother. He's going to talk about the Black Star Credit Union, and he's going to talk briefly about what he's doing to fight for Africa. He's a champion. Brother Edwin Barfo, please come up.
Greetings to you, my brothers and sisters. You're very welcome back home. This is very historic, I know, for all of you, especially when it's your first time here. This is your return, your awakening, your door opening, your everything. You're all survivors. Please give yourselves a round of applause. Real loud. Because you're all ambassadors of somebody who left these shores in the most tragic and most traumatic, the saddest, the toughest conditions. And you're all survivors who've eventually come back down here, and so you're all victorious. Really, 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 in the highest spiritual sense of it, that somebody from your line has now eventually come back through that horror and nightmare, and you're now victorious. So please, I'm serious, give yourself a round of applause. Thank you very much. As I was introduced, I'm very privileged to address you. I'm the Communications Director for Food Sovereignty Ghana. I'll speak a little bit about that, and I'll also speak about the Black Star Line Cooperative Credit Union, where I'm the chair. Now, as David mentioned, you know, and Dr. Asare mentioned already, your health is your wealth. Your health is your wealth. In fact, the human body being the most advanced creation ever made. So much intelligence that went into creating a human being. We have to understand that the fuel of the human body is organic food. The fuel of the human body that keeps the body going is organic food. If you consider how their machines, their cars, their Mercedes-Benzes, G-Wagons, watches, and everything, which have specific manuals from the manufacturer. You can't use diesel if it's a petrol car. You can't put this voltage if it's a 110 voltage. If you put it into a 210, 220, it will blow. Same thing with your body. The food that you're supposed to eat, the food that your body is supposed to consume, has been deliberately created and formulated to give you maximum output. And yet, over the years, we've traded our traditional foods for foods that are inferior, foods that have inferior nutritional, you know, makeup. And now we have the great challenge of having genetically modified organisms coming into our food chain. It's only happening because there's a large and well-funded lobby that's pushing for Ghana and other developing countries to take on genetically modified organisms. Saddest of all, it's happening in countries like Ghana, where really we have a comparative advantage to grow organic food. We run away from the sun because it's so hot. It's raining outside, we have lots of fertile soil, so Ghana should be one of the last countries going into GMO. But because of the strong lobby and the lies perpetuated, we are fed the story about the increasing population, how the population of the world will not be able to feed children anymore, and so on and so forth. But the world can farm and feed as many people as it can inhabit. It's only that the politics of food distribution is where people get an even end of the card. So Ghana is experiencing this new challenge of having policymakers who want to follow the West. And we took the government to court in 2015. We sought an injunction on the release of genetically modified cow peas and rice when we heard that the government had these plans. Unfortunately, in 2015, the injunction was thrown out. And in 2017, we decided to go to court to build a substantive case against GMO totally in Ghana. That case has dragged and dragged and dragged, but last week, one of the last obstacles that they tried to do was to throw the case out, saying that we had not invoked the proper jurisdiction of the court, and that there was a national biosafety tribunal that should rather hear our case. But the judge, in her wisdom, ruled in our favor, saying that we had every right to go to the court, especially when the tribunal that the law had said was not even in place at the time we went to court. So you have an important role here when you come to Ghana, because you're going to meet with your brothers and sisters. Our brothers and sisters find you very inspirational coming from the West. They want to hear what it is about you, have an experience that they have never had. But they need to hear the truth from you, because we get lots of images of the West that are, you know, the Disney, Hollywood, you know, the NBA, and the very rare life, the creme de la creme, and everybody thinks that that is the way everybody lives. But you have a huge responsibility in teaching our brothers and sisters this issue about GMO, keeping Ghana organic. I'm sure none of you here want to return to a land where all the foods we eat are different from the ones your ancestors knew. I don't think you want to come back to Ghana and not be able to find the old fruits, the old grains, the old seeds. Because the old food is the best food.
Yes, it is.
That's why we have grains like fonio and millets, which are traditional grains that we ate. They are alkaline in pH. They weren't acidic. So we are fighting this GMO challenge, and the people of Ghana are totally behind us. So you find that it's a small band of media people, a small band of scientists who are claiming that GMOs are safe, and they're following the bandwagon that the West has created. Ironically, it's happening at a time when Monsanto is being knocked in the US, where you've just come from. And it was only 2 weeks ago that Monsanto was given an unprecedented $2 billion lawsuit. They had to pay for damages and compensation because their flagship chemical Roundup, which contains glyphosate, is carcinogenic. This is a chemical that comes through our borders and is distributed to our regions and sprayed on our farms. And this is part of the reason we are saying that genetically modified organisms cannot be good for Ghana, because they're engineered to tolerate these deadly chemicals. So we need your support to let our brothers and sisters know, as you interact with them, that you're coming from a land where you pay a premium for organic food. Or am I lying? You walk down the supermarket and the price of organic food is about twice or three times the price of normal food.
Yeah.
So that's the first signal that should show that Ghana should take the strategic move now and produce organic food.
Yeah.
So Food Sovereignty Ghana has been in this business since 2013. This is our sixth year. Every year we've held a march against Monsanto. We just did one last week, and we held a press conference where we engaged the media again, we engaged the general public. We have a website, www.foodsovereigntyghana.org, and we just want to continue to build advocacy and help formulate policy. We were very privileged to meet the Parliamentary Select Committee on Agriculture, and when you talk to them, you can understand that the parliamentarians themselves prefer organic food to what they're busy legislating about, making rules for other people to eat. We also met the Council of States last year, and we were privileged to address them for about an hour. Three out of six people on the panel of a distinguished Council of State members immediately sided with us. Actually, on the table there, they started having, you know, discussions amongst themselves. But three of them were for us, three of them were still on the side of the government. So that shows that from the very top down, there are lots of Ghanaians who understand the implications of this, but it's about the lobby. So we need all your support. Let our brothers and sisters know the truth about GMO, because they're being told that it's safe, but it's definitely not. We need to keep our land free of chemicals so that you can see earthworms. Earthworms are a sign of the health of the soil. And now when the rain falls, you don't see so many earthworms. You go to the farms, the farmers don't find mushrooms on their land. They don't see snails anymore. So these are all reflections of the fact that Africa must remain organic, and we must not follow people like Monsanto, who knew that their chemicals were deadly and continued to push them,
yes,
to follow them, to replace the food that your ancestors and your maker wanted you to eat. So I think I'll say something quickly about the Black Star Line Credit Union, but please visit www.foodsovereigntyghana.org. We also have a Facebook page with about 13,000 followers. When you go back to wherever you live, please be an ambassador, spread the word, and let's support ourselves. We're a small organization, and most of the stuff we do comes from our small pockets, because all the big funding is on the other side with Bill Gates and Monsanto and so on.
Yeah.
So long live organic food, and long live Africa.
Amen.